Hello, I'm Hayley Leggs here at Bloodstock Festival 2014 for Total Rock with a hangover and Jørgen from Shining. Hi Jørgen, how are you feeling today?
I'm good. I don't have a hangover, but I've been traveling all night from Czech Republic. So we got off stage there half past midnight, this morning. And we've been sitting in a car and a couple of planes since then.
I bet you couldn't wait to get out and walk around after sitting down all that time traveling.
Or sitting down, have a nap. I don't know. We'll see.
So your last album, 111, came out. Sorry, I'm really bad at talking today. It was very well received. Do you think people were craving something different in the metal scene?
Yes, I think I definitely think that a lot of people wants to hear some fresh music, and it's the same with me. You know, I was just talking to a guy, and I told him that, you know, you live a short life, and you might as well check out a few things before you die, and that's the same with music. So I think definitely our music has that kind of craving for new music is helping us. People come to us to get new interesting stuff. You know?
Is that what drove you to make the kind of music you do, or is that just what happened to come out of you?
It's hard to say, but I think, basically I'm just making the music that I like myself, that I would like to listen to, and but I'm the kind of person that gets bored easily.
Yeah.
So I'm always looking for some interesting new stuff, and I always would feel a little bit bad if I felt that I was doing the same as another guy or another band. So yes, definitely. I would say that we've always been trying to make something a little bit different. But then again, the most important thing is to make something good. That's the most important thing. I don't like stuff to be different just for the sake of being different. But to me, having it interesting and a little bit different than what I'm used to contributes to making it better. See what I'm saying?
Yeah. Speaking of doing things the same, there's the other band, Shining, from Sweden, who have the same name as you. That must get confusing. Who had it first?
It's not confusing for me because I know who we are.
You know who you are. And it's confusing for journalists who are trying to research the band.
Yeah, but that's not the biggest problem in the world. And I think there are a lot of other examples with bands with that share a name. So I think...
I think you should fight to the death over the rights to the name.
Yeah,
I want you to win.
Oh, thank you. But I would like to focus on making good music, and I know that Niklas from the Swedish Shining is also of the same opinion. He just wants to, you know, make good music. So none of us really wants to spend
to
a lot of energy on that. And I think it's as long as we make sure that we say in the press releases and make sure the labels and booking agents say that we're from Norway, and they do the same. It's really just it's up now. Now it's up to the journalists to do their homework, you know. And I think after a while, actually, sometimes it's good because people, you know, the worst thing that can happen is that some people stumble upon something that they didn't expect.
Yeah.
And, you know, if they don't like it, then press stop. You know, if they like it, maybe they've discovered a new thing.
That's actually how I discovered you. I was looking for the other Shining, and I discovered something new, which is good. People ever turn up to your gig and go, oh, this isn't what I thought it was going to be.
That doesn't happen much. It doesn't really happen much. There's a lot of trolls on the internet, but they whine about all sorts of shit. When it comes to paying a couple of bucks and actually making the effort to go out and see a show, people tend to do their homework, you know.
Yeah.
So it's not a problem.
You've been touring with my lovely friends Devin Townsend Project recently, haven't you?
Yeah, we're on tour. I would say we're on tour with them now, except for these 2 days. We We've been doing 3 club shows in Europe last week. We did Brutal Assault, I would say yesterday, but it's kind of really today.
Yeah.
In Czech Republic. He also played there. We played here today, and we're doing 3 shows with him in Europe next week. So we're on a short mini tour with Devin, and that's great.
I think that's such a great combination of bands, the two of you, both such like unusual, enterprising.
Yeah, it's a nice, really nice combination. First of all, it's nice people to they are nice people to tour with. Devin and me share a lot of same taste in music. And there are obvious other links. I've played with Devin on his latest albums, it's just a great combination, while still being different. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it would be hard to find a band that sounds exactly like us. Anyhow, I think.
Yeah.
At least I haven't found one.
You also collaborated with Marty Friedland on his new album, Inferno.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
That was cool.
Yeah, that was really nice. Yeah. Yeah, they.
How did that come about?
It seems like with Black Jazz, the album Black Jazz that we released in 2010, that was Shining's 5th album. So we've been around for a long time. But with that album, we kind of established something new and something clear that people could grasp pretty quickly. And one important element of that is the saxophone and how I play the saxophone with heavy music. And it seems like a lot of people have liked that thing and felt that was a fresh thing and have wanted to kind of incorporate that and see how that would work in their music. And Devin and Marty Friedman has been a couple of these people, and that's really cool for me. I mean, first of all, I'm flattered that they want me to help out, but it's also very interesting for me. I started making music because I was interested in making music and learning new stuff, and I feel that it's a very nice way to learn more about Black Jazz and our own thing, to try to put it into other artists' music. So that was really fun. Marty,
some of yourself and your
So really, these guys are just asked me. I don't know. Marty contacted me through Twitter. Devin, probably
Andy, that isn't it?
Yeah, Devin probably the same. I was in LA and he sent me. I don't know. He just asked, "Do you want to play on the new album?" And I said yes. And I had a mic and a sound card. I was just there for like a couple of weeks, and then I recorded some stuff and I felt it sounded great and he liked it, and then that was it. And with Marty, I was in Norway in my own studio, and that took a little bit more time because we sent stuff back and forth. The idea was to kind of collaborate on writing the song. That was really fun.
Cool. Well, make sure to say hi to Devin and the guys for me on the rest of your tour.
I will.
Lovely talking to you. Thanks a lot, Jørgen.
You likewise. Thank you.
Cheers.